Hello, I'm Dani, and this is Discover Together at Halton Hills Public Library. Let's discover the Makey Makey. Today, we're going to be using this kit right here, along with some Play-Doh and a computer, to create a Pac Man controller. So, grab your tools and follow along with our video. If you'd like to check out your own Makey Makey from our Discover Together collection, visit our website at www.hpl.on.ca to borrow this kit with your library card.
For our project today, you're going to need one of our Makey Makey Discover Together kits. In this kit, you'll find a control board, along with 7 alligator clips. For today's video, we'll only be using 5. The other thing included in your Makey Makey kit is a red USB connector that looks something like this. Unlike the alligator clips, it has a USB connector on one end, and the smaller connector here, which will be connecting to the Makey Makey board itself. In addition to our Makey Makey supplies, you'll also need some Play-Doh. I've gone ahead and created 4 Play-Doh buttons. You can make your 4 buttons any shape you'd like. Since we're playing Pac-Man, I decided to go with Pac-Man shaped buttons. Likewise, these don't need to be different colors. I've selected blue as the color to signify up for today. The final item you'll need is a computer. This computer has to have a USB port to connect the Makey Makey, as well as a connection to the internet. So let's get started. The first thing you're going to want to do is take your Makey Makey board, and we're going to start attaching some of our alligator clips. First, let's attach the upward direction alligator clip. So you know the bottom is this gray section here, and these are all going to be grounding cables. I'll show you how we're going to use those in a moment. So we've connected the upward facing arrow, which we'll use to control the direction our Pac-Man travels in. And we're just going to go ahead and make sure that this silver part here of this alligator clip is fully exposed before we stick it into our Pac-Man. Next, I'm going to go ahead and connect the cable on my right in the same way. And just stick it anywhere right into our Pac-Man. Now we've made all of the connections from our Makey Makey board to our Play-Doh buttons. It's time to go ahead and connect the board to the computer. We're going to do this by inserting the cable into the USB port of the computer and the other end into our Makey Makey board. Finally, to complete the circuit, we have to attach ourselves to the board. We're going to go ahead and connect the remaining alligator clip to one of those grounding spots along the bottom. We're then going to take the connector and put it anywhere on our body. I don't recommend clipping it to your skin because it can be quite painful, but you want to clip it to your clothes or hold it in your hand. Some way to make sure that this metal part makes continual contact with your skin. I'm going to go ahead and connect it to my watch. Now it's time to go ahead and get started on our game. So we've created our buttons here. We're all connected to our Makey Makey board, and the Makey Makey board is connected to our computer. We're ready to go. So I recommend going to scratch.mit.edu. Scratch, on a side note, is a great website to learn how to code. You can type into the search board here, Pac-Man Remix Makey Makey, and select any one of these to play. I'm going to go with this one because it looks pretty cute. We're going to go ahead and click with our mouse to get started and wait while the game loads. I'm going to go ahead and make it full screen. And we can control our Pac-Man by using our arrow buttons.
The Makey Makey Kit is an electronic invention kit for all ages. You can recreate today's video using any number of conductive materials. Glasses of water, pieces of fruit, Play-Doh like we used today, or even quarters if you've got some kicking around in your wallet. Thank you for watching. Are you ready to discover something new? Go to www.hpl.on.ca and search Discover Together to put one of our kits on hold. Don't forget your library card.